I just couldn't leave California without stopping in to say hello to two of America's most respected breeders, Porter and Dickie Washington of Flacky Keyshawn fame.
When did Flacky get involved with Keys?
I believe that Dickie bought her first dog about 1945. I came into the picture with the dog in 1947.
Well, now, do I recall correctly, did that first dog go on to win Best in Show?
Oh, yes. He went Best in Show at the Los Angeles Kennel Club show.
What was his name?
Patriot Van Fitz, champion Patriot Van Fitz. There was a lady in Van Nuys by the name of Vera Fitzpatrick. Had brought some dogs over here from England, Keyshawns. Mm-hmm. And she was a native of England. And there was a man in Los Angeles by the name of Stern who used to sell dogs for people, puppies. And he would take a puppy and go into stores like I. Magnin's or Saks Fifth Avenue and walk around with it in his arms, and somebody would buy it.
Oh, Rick.
And this same thing happened to Dickie. She had bought this puppy from this woman. And when he was old enough to be shown, she began to look for a handler. And Mr. Stern suggested that she get me. So made arrangements to meet and so forth. And her sister-in-law at that time, Mrs. E.L. Doheny III, had bought several dogs from this man, too. I think she had a collie and a boxer. And so they naturally wanted me to take them right on out and show. Well, the collie wasn't much good, and the boxer was just average. But I fell in love with the Keyshawn, and he was the first one I'd ever seen.
Is that right?
Yeah. And I knew he was a show dog from the time I saw him. And I knew he could win. I didn't know I'd never read the standard. I didn't know anything about it. After we had shown a while, we took a lot of lickings, naturally. And so one instance happened in Glendale at a show. And I was pretty disgusted because I got licked by a Keyshawn. It was just mediocre. And after that Best in Show at Los Angeles, why, people began to get Keyshawns. Mm-hmm. They began to buy them from different people back east. Mm-hmm. The breed was pretty popular back on the East Coast
at that time. I didn't realize
yeah.
that.
And so I was pretty disgusted this particular day, and when I walked Dickie and her sister-in-law out to the car, I said, "Now, let me tell you something. If you get me the dogs, I'll make you the top Keyshawn woman in the world."
Good grief. That's a rather bold statement, isn't it?
She said, "Where are we going to get them?" So I got an English dog world, and she was thumbing through it. And she saw a bitch called Whimsy. It had just finished her English championship, Whimsy of Westonia. So we got on the phone, called over, and made a deal to buy the bitch. Brought her over here. Brought her over here, and from her we got some good offspring. And then we bought several other dogs from the Westonia kennels. And it was from that stock that we have produced all of our dogs, and we have never bred to an outside stud dog in over 40 years.